Two of the best teams in OCAA softball about to square off on a beautiful evening for some softball action right here at Connerville Park. The home field Humber Hawks in third place in the OCAA are taking on the second place Durham Lords, a battle of titans in the province of Ontario. We're glad to have you with us. It should be a fun one. These two teams just met a few days ago. That was an absolute barn burner. Should have some similar dynamics playing out here today. My name is Matt Hamill, alongside my broadcast partner, the one and only Zach Benoit. Zach, I mentioned it off the top. Third place Humber with a 12-2 record. Durham with a 13-1 record. Boy, what an exciting matchup here and huge implications for the ever getting closer postseason.
Yeah, and you look at it, the postseason happening here at Connerville Park on October 19th to the 21st. And this doubleheader really could implement who finishes second place in the standings, because we both know the two top teams in the league, well, they get a bye on that first day of action. You save a pitcher, you maybe save two. So big games happening here tonight.
Yeah, hugely consequential matchup here, and this will be game one of our doubleheader coming up here. Second game scheduled for an 8:30 start time. We'll step aside for the player introductions.
The Durham Lords and your Humber Hawks. And now for the starting lineups. First, for the visiting Durham Lords, we have batting first, playing second base, number 16, Gracie Earns. Batting second, playing third base, number 23, Jessica Green. Batting third, playing center field, number 19, Jocelyn Shelton. Batting fourth, designated player, number 29, Sydney Reddick. Batting fifth, playing pitcher, number 21, Chelsea Oak. Batting sixth, playing first base, number 9, Hannah Oak. Batting seventh, playing right field, number 2, Chloe Showers. Batting eighth, playing catcher, number 8, Kaylee McIntyre. Batting ninth, playing left field, number 19, Natalie Clemens. Batting 10th, playing shortstop, number 32, Riley Easton. And now the starting lineup for your Humber Hawks. Batting first, playing center field, number 3, Shay Hilker. Batting second, playing third base, number 2, Alexis Ferrara. Batting third, playing shortstop, number 7, Reese Filoki. Batting fourth, playing left field, number 15, Riley DeVries. Batting fifth, playing second base, number 20, Amelia Russo. Playing sixth, playing right field, number 12, Hannah Coziola. Batting seventh, playing pitcher, number 5, Megan Muir. Batting eighth, playing first base, number 14, Melissa Honfeld. Batting ninth, playing designated player, number 1, Allison McLaughlin. And batting 10th, playing catcher, number 10, Julia Delbuvano. At this time, we ask you to please stand if you are able and move your hats for the playing of our national anthem.
Thank you.
ratio, well, it's a pretty good one. 23 strikeouts to only 4 walks for number 5.
Up at bat first for this Durham Lords team, who sit just above Humber in the provincial standings, will be Grace Hearns.
Well, you look at number 16 in green right there. She's amongst the best in the OCAA when it comes to batting average, sitting at a 474.
First pitch from Muir comes in low for ball one.
We were talking a little bit before the broadcast started about these two teams matching up a couple days ago. It was the Durham Lords that took that one 2-1, but none of the runs were scored in regulation. Everything came in extra innings in the eighth.
Yeah, it was quite a tight game. I mean, the definition of a very tight ball game. Yeah, like you mentioned, after 7 innings of regulation, no scores. Humber actually opened up the scoring in that extra eighth inning, but it was Durham with the walk-off. 2 runs in the bottom of the eighth. Big swing there for strike thrown by Megan Muir.
And that's just a beautiful off-speed pitch, especially when they have it in high like that after pumping in 2 high fastballs. Muir, she's known for mixing her pitches very, very well.
Megan Muir is getting the start for Humber in game one, and that pitch is hit right up to Megan, who sends it over to first for the easy out number one. Good start for the home team.
And that's what you want to see so far out of the Humber Hawks. I mentioned they did drop the last game they played against the Durham Lords 2-1. Tough break. You got to look who was also on the mound for Humber. In, I guess you could say, their future ace in Shade Hansen. She faced 29 batters, went 7 1/3, and she actually walked her first runners of the year.
Yeah, the rookie sensation, Shade Hansen, who was just named the OCAA Athlete of the Week. So what a good rookie campaign from Humber's young pitcher, who we'll get to see most likely in the start of game 2, one can only assume. Outside there, great look from our outfield camera. Even up the count at 1-1. Jessica Green at bat for Durham. Beautiful throw there as Muir gets ahead in the count, 1-2. Hawks looking for out number 2. Wouldn't be surprised if we saw another low-scoring affair. I mean, first time these two teams met this season. Again, only just a few days ago. It was a tight ball game.
And at the plate, you said Jessica Green hitting 421 on the year, only has struck out 2 times.
That's hit up high in the left field. Players converging on it. There's the grab. Snagged by Riley DeVries.
Now batting number 19, Jocelyn Shelton.
Jocelyn Shelton now up to bat for the Lords. Muir's first pitch is hit into center field. And grab for out number 3. How about that play early in this game? Riley DeVries showing no signs of needing to get warmed up and springing right into action there.
Yeah, and that's a good catch right there to number 15. She's been showing how good of a season she's had on with the bat. You know, one of the best power hitters in the OCAA this year. But she also told me that, you know, she's transitioning to a new role in the outfield. Typically a right fielder, now shifting over to left field. So she explained to me that, you know, it's similar but still learning. And she's done a good job so far in the outfield. And Hawks, that's a very good and clean first inning to have. Take a quick look at the Humber Hawks lineup. It'll start like this. Shea Hilper, the center fielder, will lead things off, followed by Alexis Ferrer, who's manning the hot corner. Reese Veloci, the shortstop, batting third. Riley DeVries in left field, batting fourth. Amelia Russo, Anna Koziolek, Megan Muir, Melissa Hanfeld, and Allison McLaughlin. And then at the bottom, the flex player and that catcher, Julia DeFono. That's the starting lineup for the Humber Hawks.
Zach, I tried my best to pay attention, but when this Nelly Furtado song is on, that's really going to command all my brain cells.
You know, you got to respect Nelly Furtado.
And the Timberland.
Of course.
Nelly Furtado, Canadian icon who's making quite a comeback as of late. Nelly Furtado in the spotlight in a big way.
Good for Nelly.
Yeah.
So you mentioned that order, and yes, that will indeed bring up center fielder Shay Hilpert up to bat for the Humber Hawks, number three in her second year with the program. Humber is head coached by Dwayne Bowles in his seventh year with the program, and on the other side, another experienced head coach, Jamie Baker. This Durham team has seen no shortage of success. They've been certainly capturing their fair share of provincial championships. Durham won four provincial titles in a row from 2015 to 2018. Also captured the provincial gold in the 2021-22 season.
Yeah, and that dominance that Durham has had, well, we've seen it for a while. You mentioned, like you said, they had those big title runs. And I believe that's also a record. Going back and quickly checking my stats, it is. So most consecutive OCAA championships was four, and that was done by the Durham Lords, 2015 to 2018.
Also have the most overall championships in OCAA with 21 provincial chips all time. But really, Zach, you look back at recent years, and it's the Humber Hawks, the Durham Lords, the St. Clair Saints, who just seem to be trading the distinction of top team in the province. Humber finishing the past two seasons with the bronze, capturing the provincial gold the year before that.
And you look at the standings, it goes St. Clair still undefeated at 14-0, Durham Lords sitting at 13-1, and then the Humber Hawks 12-2. The next closest team is Seneca at 5-7. It's just been the three top teams just dominating.
But like you mentioned, it's great to have such separation between from the 1, 2, and 3 place teams from the rest of the OCAA, but 1 and 2 really makes such an impact. Like you highlighted, Zach, those are the two teams who get the first round bye of the OCAA championships here at Connerville Park a bit later in October.
Yeah, and it's very crucial and very vital to have one of those first or second place finish. And you look, there's a lot of big softball games coming up. The Durham Lords, Humber Hawks, and St. Clair, they all play each other a bunch.
Good at bat for Shay Hilpert, who draws ball number three for a full count. Not a bad start for the Hawks offensively, working this first at bat.
Yeah, and Hilpert, a menace on the base paths. She gets on, just 10 stolen bases so far this year.
Hilpert slaps it, finds a bit of a gap, and she'll make her way easily over to first and pumps the brakes as the Hawks not too bad on the first at bat. Getting a runner on base, and that brings up the veteran Alexis Ferreira.
Potent power by number two up to bat. And Hilpert, again, just what you like to see out of the leadoff spot. Just get on base and keep passing that torch down the line. She had a career high, 4 hits in one game. That happened about a week and a half ago.
Ferreira second on the team, tied for second with 2 home runs on the season. And Kosiolek also with 2 dingers. Leading the team with home runs for Humber this year is second year player Riley DeVries. And over safe at first as Hilpert scrambles.
You look at the top 5 in home runs, Humber has 3 out of the top 5. I mentioned all those names. Riley DeVries with 3, Hannah Koziolek with 2, and as well, Alexis Ferreira with 2.
Outside for ball number 2. Making that a 2-1 count. Chelsea Oak pitching for the Lords. Throwing a good strike there to even things up.
You want to talk about a little bit of dominance that Ferreira's had? Well, she had a streak break last game. There were 7 straight games where she recorded an RBI.
And how about that? Like you mentioned, Zach, Hilpert darts over to second and almost thinks about maybe heading over to third. Doesn't take long for Hilpert to dirty up that all-white uniform as true to form, early success running the bases.
And Hilper just wanted to tie her teammate Ferreira for the league lead in stolen bases, both sitting at 11 now.
I'm sure that was the only thing on her mind. And Ferreira struck out, so a good bounce back there after the Hawks first at bat goes as planned. Hilpert stealing second. Ferreira facing a tough pitcher in the rookie Chelsea Oak. Chelsea has a sister, Hannah Oak, on the team who has been a very productive member of their batting order. Up to bat for Humber right now, Reese Veloci.
First-year player for Humber, and the starting shortstop really took those reins over after an early season injury happened to last year's shortstop, Emilio Russo, who's back in the lineup.
And that's hit up the second baseline, and that's going to bring home Hilbert. And that throw to home will allow Veloci attempt at second, and she's called safe. Fantastic at-bat there. Veloci with the double, bringing home the runner.
And continue to have a great rookie campaign. Reese Veloci coming in today, batting 468, 17 RBIs. Will now make that 18. On top of her game right there.
Bringing up Riley DeVries. At bat for Humber. So last time these two teams met, again, that was just back on Sunday. It took the Hawks until the eighth inning to put up a run. And certainly a reversal of fortunes here, maybe making some adjustments. Allowing the Hawks to get out to an early 1-0 lead. Pitch comes in high. Tip there for strike two.
DeVries having a phenomenal season. She did so as well last year with the bat. Batted 475, currently batting 447. But now she has more at-bats than she did last year. Becoming a really potent player out there in left field.
And strike three for out number two. Good start on the mound for the Lords. Chelsea Oak now with two strikeouts here. Hawks have a runner on second after that double hit by Veloci. Pitch comes in high. Seen a few pitches come in rather high, and that would, of course, a wild pitch would give Veloci a good opportunity to advance over to third.
See Russo on that pitch, a little bit out ahead of it, but still reading it very, very well. As a hitter, you want your bat to stay through the plane of the plate the entire time. Don't really want to have that arch in it. Russo does a good job doing that.
And British Columbia's Emilia Russo hits that, finds a gap. That's going to be a close call at home. Bobbled run number two scoring for Humber as Veloci makes her way to home plate thanks to a nice hit off the bat of Kelowna's Emilia Russo.
That's what you want to see. The middle infield for the Hawks working strong right there. The second baseman cashing in the shortstop. Emilia Russo, you know, started the season a little bit late due to an injury, but has really bounced back and brought a lot of good positivity into that lineup for the Hawks.
Humber Hawks starting out inning number one, very strong defensively, making quick work of the Lords. And very good offense here as Koziolek pops that one up real high. A couple of Lords giving chase. That will land foul. Coach Dwayne Bowles having a chat with Koziolek there on the left side of your screen. They're trying to pump up number 12.
And it seems offensively everything is going right for Humber this year. A lot of these players in the lineup, well, this is maybe some of their best years. And Koziolek, she's closing in on some of her career highs.
High pitch there for ball one. Yeah, the Hawks have put up 123 runs this season. They've allowed 28. Durham, a little bit more fluid offensively. They put up 153 runs as Koziolek slaps it up to third. Throw over to first is handled for out number three. After one inning of play, the Humber Hawks jumping out to a nice two-run lead.
Yeah, and it's really just good small ball performed right there by Humber. You know, Shea Hilpert gets on, uses the speed to get on a second, and then you have some of your big boppers help her get on over. Same thing with Emilia Russo and Reese Veloci. Just good small ball action by Humber in that bottom of the first.
Let's take a look, a second look at all three outs plus the runs, and there was strikeout number one on Alexis Ferreira. And There's that slap up that second base line, bringing home the opening run of the game. That made it 1-0. Hunter was safe at second on that play. And then it was Reese Veloci. Another great hit. Good second look here. Humber ultimately having that two-run lead. But it's some good pitching as well. A couple of strikeouts thrown by number 21, Chelsea Oak. There's that play at home plate. Just not quite ripped at bat, at the home plate rather. Out number three. So that was a recap of that bottom of the first. Zach, you got to think the Humber Hawks like what they've seen. Always such a big advantage to get off to a hot start, especially when your offense was really so stalled in the previous matchup. Granted, both teams' offenses had a hard time getting going the last time these two teams met.
For sure, and I think it just comes down to that pitching matchup. You had some of the best pitchers going at it last game, and I think we'll probably see them again tonight. Shade Hansen on the mound for Humber last night, and while you look over on the side of Durham, it was Emily Glendenning. She also went the full game. Both of those players, partner, sit atop the league in earned run average. Shade Hansen at a .17 and Glendenning at a .47, so two of the best.
So good strike thrown to open things up in inning number two. From Megan Muir. Sydney Reddick is up to bat for Durham right now. Reddick will watch that go for strike number two. Reddick has hit the only home run for the Durham Lords this season.
Really like that pitch mix right there by Muir. Has the two fastballs on the inner half, then tries to break off the edge there with a good spinner.
Outside for ball two, evened up here, 2-2. Reddick at 25 at-bats, has 9 hits this season. See if Megan Muir can get the strikeout here. One strike away. And we will have a full count here after the first base official weighs in. The Durham Lords respond with a bit of offense of their own after the Humber Hawks jump out to an early lead. Reddick hits that up towards second base. It's mishandled. So a shortstop play will just come up empty, and that will allow Durham to get on base.
Unfortunate break there for Humber, but again, good pitch mix on the mound by Muir. That's what you want to see. Just get a lot of weak contact, because we know how potent this Durham Lords offense is. Second best in the league. And if you can keep having that weak contact and those ground balls, it's a good job on the mound.
Chelsea Oak, we've seen her do some great pitching thus far this game. Couple of strikeouts and now up at bat for the green and yellow. And after Chelsea Oak, right up next, her sister Hannah Oak will be hitting right after in the order.
You talked about good pitching. Well, batting .500 on the year is Chelsea Oak.
Dual threat, we used to call that back in my day.
Now you just call it the Shohei Ohtani.
Hit up high. This one is almost grabbed. That thing came down like a Predator missile. That was unable to be gloved down. So the at-bat continues for Oak.
And that's the smart play to do. So whenever you have a pop-up like that as a catcher, little words of wisdom for anybody watching, whether you're a softball player or a baseball player, it was a good idea of what Devono did. You turn your back immediately to the infield. It makes the play a little bit easier for you. Obviously right there, just tracked it a little bit too much forward. But that's what you want to see, you know, as a catcher, doing the right thing.
have a change. We're going to be seeing Reddick out of the batting order, substituting out for, or on base, in her place, Alana Smail.
A little bit more speed on the bases right there for the Durham Lords, trying to get the offense going after falling down early 2-0.
So a 2-1 count for Oak. She hits it hard deep into right field. Glove down nicely, though, as the Hawks secure out number one here in the second inning.
Good play by Hannah Koziolak, who transitioned over from a center fielder to a right fielder. And she's done a very good job of it so far this year. Really manning the corner out there very, very well.
Bringing up now the other Oak sister, Hannah, who has a runner on first base, the third-year player looking to spark some offense for this Durham team. Strike one for Megan Muir.
387 average coming into today. Two triples out of number nine in green, so she has the speed.
That one comes in low. Over to first base, who says that was in fact a swing. So 0-2 count. As Hannah Oak finds herself behind in her first at-bat of the game. Megan Muir puts that for ball one. Over to second, and that is good for the out. Beautiful throw from Julia Devuano.
Yeah, a great throw down, beat the runner, and a good tag at shortstop too, because what you want to see out of a shortstop is when they get the ball, drop the glove immediately to the base. Don't try to reach out for the runner. Good job by Veloci right there.
And there's strike three. How about that for this defensive start for Humber, as the Hawks will keep the Lords off the board after two innings of work.
Yeah, and that's just huge to see, especially after it was a leadoff error that got things rolling for Durham. You thought maybe this could be a big inning for them. Nope. Humber shuts it down right away. And like you said, great defensive plays all around.
Let's take a look at some of those top of the second highlights as our Hawks Sports Network replay is in full effect right now. That pitch came in from Megan Muir, and that was good for that extra effort there out at second, thanks to Julia Devuano.
And you see it again right here. The thing that I love the most about this play is look at the shortstop. Immediately drops the glove down to the base. So if you're a player and you're sliding into that, you can't really do anything, especially if you're going feet first.
And here's that inning ending strikeout. Oak wasn't happy with it, gave the umpire a little what for on her way to the dugout, but can the Humber Hawks pick up where they left off and keep the offense a-rockin' and a-rollin'? Up to bat first is the young lady we've seen pitching so far for tonight, for Humber tonight, Megan Muir.
A pitcher versus pitcher duel here. As Chelsea Oak, I was going to mention it last thing, but typically we see, you know, pitchers here in the OCAA sitting around that mid to high 50s. Oak above that.
Yeah, quick pop right to open the inning, but that is handled nicely by Durham for out number one. Muir not able to make it over there quite in time.
A very bang-bang play.
That heads-up defense from the Lords, and that brings up now for the Humber Hawks, Melissa Honfeld. Hanfeld, who plays first base for the Hawks by way of Georgetown. Shout out to Georgetown. And that pitch comes a little high.
In a rookie campaign, the action was cut just a little bit short. Only played 9 games. This year, already 14, and really just been the Hawks' first baseman every single day. Always out there, plays terrific defense.
tip there for strike one. Good bounce back, Zach, for Durham, getting that quick first out, not allowing that Humber offense rhythm to pick up where it left off there in inning number one. Enfeld gets a nice hit, and that is gloved down. Beautiful effort there. Making that outstanding catch to give the Lords their second out.
Yeah, Riley Easton over there at shortstop. She's doing a really good job defensively. She's already made one strong throw across the diamond right there. Kind of lunging out for it.
So the second inning defense from Lords coming almost entirely off the hands of Riley Easton. Allison McLaughlin at bat for Humber now hits that one foul.
Good job of staying with that pitch right there. It looked like it was set up for the outside half, and she tried to take it the other way down the right field line.
The rookie McLaughlin, related to Canadian pop superstar Sarah McLaughlin. I don't know if that's true, but while we're on the conversation of Canadian pop stars, Nelly Furtado.
Yeah, bring back Nelly Furtado. Somehow, Furtado always finds
St. Louis, Missouri rapper Nelly related to Canadian pop icon Nelly Furtado. McLaughlin will watch that go by. Called a strike, so the count even at 2-2. Oak will send that in, a soft hit. This should be an easy throw for out number three. That's how it plays out. So after two innings of play, we're right where we were after one. 2-0 lead for the Humber Hawks.
Yeah, and first off, that was just a really good pitch mix right there by Oak to get McLaughlin out in front of it. But again, we got to take a look at the lunge out snap that was by Riley Easton. Look at this play right here. Gets it all out, full extension to get the grab.
How about that angle from our Hawk Sports Network camera crew capturing that excellent defensive play by Riley Easton. Add that to the highlight reel.
You can see the first base coach, Brandon Costa, just tipping the cap, because sometimes that's all you can really do when a defender makes a great play like that.
Inning number three almost underway. Now would be a good time to remind you, if you like the softball action you're seeing here in game one, we'll stick around on the Hawk Sports Network. Game two, these two teams will run it back with an 8:30 start time or half an hour after the conclusion of this game, whichever comes first.
Either way, don't go anywhere. We've got a lot of good action here and a lot of important games tonight. You know, like we mentioned at the start of the broadcast, these two games can really make or break and determine who finishes second, possibly first. You know, we don't know what's going to happen later on in the season. There's a lot of big games coming up on the tail end of this OCAA softball season.
That's a good point. Regardless of the outcome of this particular evening of softball games, still a lot of games to be played looking ahead in the season, but of course, you're just looking at the three top teams in the province and then the huge gap between the rest of the teams in Ontario. You'd think this would be a hugely consequential game. Nice hit to start off the inning. That was courtesy of Chloe Showers, second-year player from Uxbridge, giving the Lords a bit of life early in the third.
And a good job by the shortstop Veloci to lay out and probably prevent extra bases from happening right there. It's a good job, but also a nice hit, like you said, by Showers.
Kaylee McIntyre up to bat now. Durham Lords sitting just above Humber in the provincial standings. And we'll have a little conference on the Humber Hawk mound here.
One thing to know, partner, both of these teams will actually be going out for the Nationals That'll be played on October 8th out in BC. We'll be doing that. That's why you see there's a little bit of a break in the season. Humber will play a doubleheader against Mohawk on October 1st. Then there's a break till October 14th. And, well, that's because Humber Hawks, they're over there in the Canadian Collegiate Softball Association National Championship hosted by the University of Victoria from October 6th to the 8th.
And how about that? The Hawks' first game back, Zach, right against the top team in the province, the St. Clair Saints. How about this action right here? Not bad work. Humber able to secure one out on the play. Got to give full credit there. That was an athletic-looking play from Hanfeld with the splits at first. So Humber Hawks secured the first out of the inning. That brings up to bat now number 18, Natalie Clemens. Strike one. So Zach, we again mentioning that doubleheader game, the second one of the evening. You'd imagine we're going to see Glendenning on the mound for the Lords, Shade Hansen for the Hawks. What an exciting pitching duel that hypothetically is.
And if the first game between these two teams indicated anything, it's going to be a very good pitcher's duel. You know, you'd expect these two teams being two of the top three teams in offense in the OCAA this year to just go at it, slugging hits for hits, but they also have really good pitching staffs.
It's popped up high for the strike.
Like I mentioned, Hanson leading the league in ERA with a .17, and then Glendenning right behind her with a .47.
1-2 count. Megan Muir hoping to find out number two for Humber. Here comes her pitch. And that will be ball two.
Good job there by Clemens to hold the bat back. You did see her starter swing. And the judgment there is just if she broke the plane of the plate or not with her swing. And then obviously right there, the field ump didn't think so.
Slapped up right to Muir, zips it over to first. The double play opportunity not quite there. So the Hawks will settle for one out on that play. Durham Lords with a runner on second, still looking for their opening run of the game. Perhaps they can get it off the bat of Natalie Clemens.
Yeah, we're back to the top of the order.
Pardon me, Grace Hearns. That's 6-8.
The jerseys are tough, you know.
There is literally no space between the crest of that six anyway. Stop trying to defend myself as Hearns pops it deep into center field, and that will land. So one run scores for Durham, making this a 2-1 ball game, and Hearns makes it over to second. It's quite a funky dance as she arrives at second base.
Yeah, and Hearns, you know, one of the top hitters in the OCAA, as mentioned on her first at-bat, shown right there why. Tough play in center field for Hilper. There's no warning track out there, so you know you got to really have your outfielders talking, and Hearns just takes off.
Caught the Hawks snoozing there, so looks like the Durham Lords offense really starting to come alive here. Hawks need one more out to extinguish this third inning surge of offense. Pitch comes in high.
Well, I talked about earlier, Hilpert wanted to join Ferreira in the league lead for stolen bases. Well, so did Hearns. Now all again tied up at 11.
Hearns entered this game leading her team in hits. Not a bad spot in one of the province's top offenses. The ball comes in, so a 3-0 count. Advantage for Jessica Green here. Looking to bring home the game-tying run. Nice strike thrown there from Muir.
Good bounce back pitch. Looked like a fastball in the outside corner.
Zach, you can see right over the shoulder of Green. You have two Humber Hawks, three Humber Hawks legends in the softball department. Aaliyah Davidson, Bonnie Gillingham, the hits queen. And the fantastic pitcher, Miranda Pearson, that's hit into right field. Zach, that ball will land. The Lords have tied up this game. And Green will make her way over to third. So how about this response from the visiting team here in inning number three, evening things up.
And I think this is what we kind of expected out of Durham, right? They have the second best offense in the OCAA, and they're showing it right here. And why? It's just a good power hit over there in right field, and looked like Koziolek just kind of got a little bit handcuffed trying to chase that one down to the corner.
So a little conference here for the Humber Hawks, trying to regroup. Just need one more out here to close things out.
And if you're Muir, you got to look at this inning as, you know, just try to get out of it unscathed. Worst case scenario, they get out of it, and it's a tie ball game. Back to the slate of 0-0.
Put a little pressure on the Humber Hawks offense to respond in the bottom of the third. But as of right now, it's a tie game. Ball thrown from Muir. Megan Muir sends another ball low for a 2-0 count. Hawks are hoping to win the game here and even up the season series at 1-1. Foul ball, that trickles over towards third base.
And not only would it even up the season series, but it would also put the Hawks in a tie for second place, meaning making that third game tonight really matter a little bit more.
Make a doubleheader game later this evening. That already means a lot, mean a whole lot. 2-1 count. Muir trying to close out this third inning. Slapped right towards Megan. That'll make its way into center field. The go-ahead run touches home plate as Jessica Green makes her way to the dish. Now it's a three-run third inning that has allowed the Lords to steal that lead away from the home team Hawks.
Tough break right there. Good off-speed, it looked like, on the outside half, but Green just takes it right back up the middle, and that's what you want to do on pitches on the other half.
Ball one thrown to Sydney Reddick. Reddick watches that go to even up the count. Nice strike throw there by Megan Muir. Muir, that pitch is hit by Reddick, so 1-2 is the count.
Looked like an inner half fastball there. Well, see what the mindset is of Devono and Muir here, what they want to do. My best guess would be try to get her going with a pitch on the outer half. Look for something off speed, low and away.
And a run over to second. That will not be in time. In fact, the ball mishandled. So a stolen base there as Durham continues with the offensive excellence here.
Durham, another good team when it comes to base running. Humber has been so potent about it this year. Durham right behind him.
Ball two. Check that, it's a full count. Three balls, two strikes. Hit hard, and that will be fair as the Lords bring home another run, and that will be ruled a double as that ball finds its way out of the field of play after landing fair. Zach, how about this offensive explosion by the visiting team?
And we had a perfect view of that one down the left field line. You can still see right where the ball landed on the middle of the chalk line.
Very dramatic kick up of white dirt. Hawks having a tough time getting out of this inning, sitting at two outs here. Now Megan Muir is facing the pitcher, Chelsea Oak. We're back to the pitcher-on-pitcher battle on the dish and at the plate.
It's just been a really good answer back from Durham, and you kind of knew that was going to happen, just didn't know when. This is why they've been one of the most potent teams in the OCAA this year.
One count. Oak hits a blistering shot. That gets by Ferreira. That's deep into left field, and we have another run making its way home, and the runs continue to pile up for Durham. An explosive five-run third inning, and we're not out of the woods yet, as that brings up the other Oak sister, Hannah Oak, who came into this game, Zach, leading the team in RBIs.
Yeah, and what we've seen the last two batters is just those shots hit right down the third baseline. It's a tough break. That'll knock Megan Muir out of the ballgame.
So Megan Muir steps out. And it looks like Michaela Moore will come in for relief.
Again, you don't want to ever see that, especially out of a player that's been so consistent over her entire career. Tough break. Durham, again, just showing how good of an offense they really have. It's a tough break for number five. See it there, this Michaela Moore and a good old heavy metal partner.
Kind of scared you there, right? With the Metallica blasted in and kind of cut you off.
I was waiting for her to start. That was kind of what happened there.
So Moore will get warmed up. Looks like she's ready to go. Thumbs up to Duano. And Moore gets the high fives all around, getting juiced up by the team, and just has to get one more out here. But boy, oh boy, it's just been the runs matriculating for this Durham team, now up 5-2. Moore's first pitch comes in high. Tough assignment, partner, checking into the game, Michaela Moore, and facing off against a pretty threatening hitter here, the 6'1" Hannah Oak.
And really what you want to do when you come into a game like this is just focus on one job.
Oak slaps that over towards third base, and that is caught for out three, and holding the splits there at first base. What a dramatic play. We'll see the replay of that, I'm sure, coming up in just a moment. But Zach, the Hawks stopped the bleeding and finished the inning, surrendering five runs.
Again, you look at it, we saw it from the shortstop of the Durham Lords unit, and Reese Feloci right there doing it herself. Nice play, but like you said, five come across for the side of Durham. And, oh man, that's just, it's a tough break when you see the offense explode like that. You got to hope Humber can have some sort of answer back here. But like you said, I'm sure we'll see another replay of that play right there.
Well, coming up in just a moment, we'll take a look at some of those big plays from inning number three, and it was just the offensive explosion, and it really got things going. It's that RBI double, and we had another one of those helping to add up the runs for this Durham team, and one of those hits right here, just out of reach. And so, Zach, you got to think the Lords like the response they've seen there.
Yeah, the impact of this half inning now is probably going to be the biggest. If you look at it, if Humber's able to answer back, even say get one, maybe two runs, that's huge in momentum swing for the rest of the game. But if Durham can shut them down here, Durham, they can put a very big stranglehold on the game. You see, there's that beautiful back foot throw by Reese Veloci. And again, you just got to tip your cap. We've seen good defense all day long. Veloci just added to it right there.
Thing of beauty there for the Hawks getting that third out, but ultimately it's the Lords who come out of that half inning with the smiles, as it is going to be the Hawks now. Bottom of the third, a chance to respond with some offense. Zach, how important is it right here for Humber to drum up a couple of response runs here?
Huge, and it all starts with the leadoff batter, Shea Hilpert. Just try to get something going for your side, you know, get on base. She does such a good job when she's on the base paths, you know, getting into scoring position and really causing havoc for the pitcher.
Hilpert shows bunt there, gets a piece of it for strike one.
I mentioned it on the 21st against Sheridan. Hilper had a four-hit game. It's her career high.
Chelsea Oak puts that pitch high out of the reach of her catcher.
Oak had a big rest that innings. Was down for a while, so you know, still a lot of power in the arm, but maybe not as much consistency as she would love right now to start the inning.
One-one count for Hilpert at the plate. Ball two, another pitch comes in high from Oak.
Again, a good job by Hilpert. What you want to see out of the leadoff batter for the side of Humber is try to get something going.
How about that slap? That's going to find the shortstop over to first and called safe as the Humber Hawks get a good response in the first at-bat.
One thing that you like to see running down the baseline there with Hilpert is she didn't extend to take a big step. She just kind of went straight to the bag, sliding her foot. And really that millisecond, you know, thought process of what you should do, we'll see it here again. She doesn't extend, just drops the foot to the base.
Lords are less than enthused with that call, but no outs here. Hawks with a runner on first. Hilpert will zip over to second. And Shea Hilpert continues with her base-stealing ways.
Again, what can you really say? That's what you want to see out of the leadoff batter. Hilpert just does such a good job when she's on the bases.
Brings up the veteran Alexis Ferreira for the Hawks. Ferreira will watch ball one go by. The Hawks put up two runs in the opening inning, gave them a lead there. They are now down by three. No better time than the present to answer with some offense of their own after giving up five to Durham in the top of this inning. Strike thrown there by Oak. Chelsea Oak has been making it not so easy for the Hawks. Some good pitching thus far here in this game. That's popped up right to the pitcher, and Ferreira called out at first. Hilpert, though, advancing to third.
Just doing a job right there, you know. You want to answer back for at least one if you're the Hawks in this half inning. Ferreira, it's, you know, you didn't get on base, but it's okay because you still advanced the runner up to third.
Reese Veloci up to bat for Humber. First-year player by way of Rexdale. And how about that hit? That had all kinds of power on it. That will bring home Hilpert as the Hawks respond and make this a two-run ball game.
Again, Veloci having a good day at the plate. Recorded the first RBI of the game in the first inning. She gets her second of the day. And how about that swing? You know, staying behind it, there's a lot of velocity coming out of the arm of Oak on the mound. And Veloci right there staying behind it and just driving the ball.
Had some pop, Zach. Capital P, capital O, capital P, and hit right over to second. The Hawks are going to be safe. Excellent work there. Quick hit off the bat of DeVries, and Zach, the Hawks are rolling here in the bottom of the third.
I'll go down as a fielder's choice. We'll take a look at it. It was a little bit of a bobble and a good job by Veloci to get the foot in there. Now Amelia Russo, the other Humber Hawk that has an RBI today, will step up.
some fun Latin pop music to get the crowd going here.
You gotta love it.
It's like even you're moving the hips right now.
Of course.
And we have the head coach for the Lords, Jamie Baker, out on the field having a quick discussion with the shortstop. And we're right back to the action. The Humber Hawks with a runner on second and first. One out. Good opportunity to answer back. First pitch comes in high for ball number one.
One thing to notice about when Russo swings, and I mentioned it last time, her barrel stays through the entire time. She can get something to barrel here. Looking at a run scoring.
Russo hits a short one for out number two, but both Humber runners advance.
And not taking the out at third, a little bit surprising right there was Jessica Green. You know, you thought maybe she'd try to step on her base and throw it across the diamond, but you know, she'll take the sure out.
Hennikozy Olick, fifth-year veteran for the Humber Hawks. Big opportunity. She could potentially give the Hawks some much-needed runs right now.
Check swing went off, I believe, either the handle of the bat of Cozy Olick.
Hawks got off to the quick start in this game, put them in the driver's seat, but it was Durham with a big response. Looks like the Hawks still have a window of opportunity to take back control of this game. Cozy Olick at bat. Cozy Olick hits that one deep. That will be caught for out number three. Goodness gracious, what a play out in left field.
If that landed, that was a fair ball and was definitely going to be scoring two. Tip your cap to Natalie Clemens. I mean, wow, what a catch. A little bit speechless after that one. Wow.
Well, it was a huge pop off the bat from Cozy Olick. And what a momentous play of this game. I mean, that would have, if that landed, Zach, could have blown the game wide open. Certainly would feel like the Hawks would have brought home the game-tying run. But grabbed out in left field. Excellent work there, Natalie Clemens.
And this was the RBI that Humber scored. And, you know, even though it is just one, there's still a lot of game left for the Hawks to keep striking and clawing back. The answer back there was huge, because if they didn't, you know, Durham could still have that momentum on their side and try to run away with it.
And how about one more look at the catch just on the left side of your screen there. And that was dynamite as the Humber Hawks remain two runs down after three innings of play. Zach, the big question now is, can the Durham Lords continue with the offensive mojo, or does the pitching change for Humber now with Michaela Moore in the game? Is that going to help the Hawks kind of turn a new leaf here? It certainly looked like it. Moore came into the game and Hawks had that quick, nice, beautiful throw over to first off a pop from the Lords. So only time will tell, partner.
For sure. And all you really kind of hope out of the arm here of Michaela Moore is just, you know, just give your team some innings. You know, you don't typically want to see your starter go out so early on. But if Moore can go out there and, you know, provide some strong innings for the Humber Hawks against a good Durham Lords team, that's big for the offense also.
Up to bat first in inning number four, Chloe Showers.
She led things off last inning for that big inning for Durham.
That was the inning that just would not end for the Humber Hawks. Kayla's first pitch for ball one.
The appeal down to first, did not go over.
Moore sends that one in low for ball two.
That's a good pitch mix to use. You know, you start the at-bat off with a high fastball and try to go outside corner with the off-speed. Unfortunately, the batter's not biting at it.
And there's strike one. Zach, the season of autumn began on Saturday, but I'll tell you what, still not too chilly out here tonight. We should only get down to about 17 degrees by the end of the doubleheader here. So
you'd say autumn, I just say sweater weather.
Got that hoodie activated, popped up just over the head of Ferreira, and that's going to make its way into the outfield as the Lords make it to first base on the first batter of the inning.
Yeah, you get a weak contact chopper like that, it's just unfortunate that it takes that one big bounce over the head of Ferreira.
Great work by Chloe Showers to get the party started for Durham right where they left off. And now, up to bat, Kaylee McIntyre, fifth-year player for Durham. And that strike thrown there by Moore, good bounce back.
You know, we're so used to hearing the cheers from the Humber Hawks dugout.
It's nice to get some refreshing songs from the visiting team.
This is
a particularly good one. I don't know if I can
repeat. Let's not. Let's not and say we did. Took us both by surprise there. It's the look.
Kaylee McIntyre, K-Mac, up at bat with a 1-2 count. McIntyre swings and comes up empty as Moore gets the strikeout, and the Hawks on the board here with out number one.
That's a good job after the leadoff base. The leadoff base runner you see there. And it's a good strikeout bounce back from Michaela Moore. Had me laughing there, partner.
Natalie Clemens, who had an absolutely extraordinary catch to end off the third inning. Up to bat now. Well, I'll tell you what, give Durham 5 stars for the dugout chants and songs coming from their direction.
Including barking. You know, like you said, 5 stars.
Bunt laid down by Clemens. That'll sit right in front of Duvano. Now you have runner over to third. It's called out. Some ill-advised base running there. Confusion has taken over.
Yeah, there's a little bit of confusion even at home plate right here in front of us. You know, Ferreira and Duvano just didn't know who was going to pick it up.
Looks like we have a Humber Hawk a little worse for wear.
Looks like when she slid, when I believe Chloe Shower slid into third base, it just caught the cleat or the side of DeVries. She'll be okay though, running back out there to left field. But yeah, there was a close play at third and a little bit of confusion at home plate, and then I guess a little bit of confusion running the bases. DeVries did a good job of coming in from left field to cover. That's huge.
So DeVries shakes it off, and Grace Hearns now up to bat.
Back to the top.
Moore throws the strike, runner over to second, that ball is jarred loose. So a stolen base there will put the runner on second for Durham.
Yeah, when you see the throwdowns, you want to just try to keep it on that left side of the base, just so right there, you don't have to bring the ball across your body. If it's just brought down right where the runner is sliding, it's an easy tag for the shortstop or the second baseman.
So the Humber Hawks, with two outs, looking to get the third out here and keep this Durham offense off the board. The umpire kind of helping out there. That pitch got loose but hit the foot of the ump, helping Devano keep it in play. A little lucky bounce there. But the runner now on third for Durham, threatening to make this once again a three-run ball game. Top of the fourth, Hawks down by two right now. That's popped up high. Couple of Hawks in the mix, and there it is, glove down for out number three, Reese Veloci, first-year player. Make no mistake about that one. So what a bounce-back inning for Humber, the previous inning allowing five runs. Zach Zilch in that outing, and that's a good step in the right direction for this home team, who now trail.
Yeah, you said it best, you know, and there's two big takeaways for me watching that inning. One, Caleb Moore, it's a really good job of just coming into the game and just getting a strong outing right there. And then for the defensive side of things, Humber, you get the shutdown you wanted. That's what you want to see. Now it's time for the bats to answer. Can they answer back here and keep responding and clawing at this lead?
Returning to the mound will be Chelsea Oak. First-year player has done a good job of limiting that Hawks offense. Of course, Humber able to put up a run in the bottom of the third, Zach. Looked like maybe they had more in the barrel, but it was the Durham defense shutting things down, and in particular, that outstanding grab in left field, courtesy of Natalie Clemens.
And me and you were looking at each other, partner, when the pitching change was made, trying to figure out who would be hitting, if it would be the flex player, Julia Devano or Caleb Moore. Well, now we get our answer. Caleb Moore will pitch as well as hit in this game.
5'1", Caleb Moore, up to bat.
And if one thing I've learned from Marcus Stroman, height doesn't measure heart.
I concur, partner.
Look at another person in the MLB. Alejandro Kirk, 5'8".
Well, the Hawks trail by two. And that hit by Moores right up to the third base, and that will be over to first for out number one. Good start here in the bottom of the fourth for Lords.
And it was a good swing right there, and it looks like the ball just kind of got more on the hands. And if you're a pitcher, that's what you want to do. You just want to keep missing barrels like that.
Here comes Melissa Hanfield. I'm still not over the splits move she did to grab that out at first base.
We've seen that a couple of times this year, and every time I see it, it hurts me a little bit more.
Yeah, I get a vicarious groin injury just watching someone with that mobility.
Tip your cap right there to the pitcher, Chelsea Green. Two straight fastballs pumped on the inside, and then a wicked slow off-speed, which kind of trickles and fools Hanfield into fouling it off.
Two count. Hanfield gets a piece of that one to stay alive here.
And I like that approach right there. You know, when you're at the plate, what you want to do is sit fastball just to an off speed. And that's what Hanfield just did right there. Was sitting on the fastball, and she was ready to adjust if needed.
That one's popped foul over towards the Humber dugout. Head coach Dwayne Bowles getting out of the way. Avoid getting hit by that ball.
It's a good at-bat here from 1-4.
O-2 count for Hanfield. Ball one. As Oak sends that one high and a bit to the right.
That's a tough riser to lay back on, but a good job just to bite the bullet and not swing.
Yeah. There's ball two. Hit inside, says the umpire.
You see Oak ask on the mound saying, was that inside? And the umpire saying, yep.
Oak looking for the strikeout. 2-2 count. Hit by Handfell. This should be easy for out number two. That brings up ninth in the batting order, Allison McLaughlin.
Can you name that walk-up song, partner?
Nelly. St. Louis, Missouri's Nelly. Tip there on the bunt for strike one.
Looked like she wanted to bunt, but was in the process of pulling it away, and it just kind of caught her when it was brought back.
Swing and a miss for strike two. Durham not allowing Humber any kind of offensive mojo here in the bottom of the fourth thus far. Looking for that third and final out. There it is. So the Hawks, after squeezing out a single run in the bottom of the third, come up empty here, and it remains 5-3 ball game.
And it just seems like right now, Chelsea Oak just has the bottom half of the order figured out for Humber. Second time she settled the 7-8-9 hitters down 1-2-3.
So it'll be for the Hawks back on the mound. Michaela Moore hoping to continue to stall this Durham offense. But Zach, for Durham, you got to think they're not content with a two-run lead here, especially knowing what the Hawks are capable of offensively. But we'll see if it's Durham who can add a few insurance runs here as we're getting late into the game here. Later stretches of the game.
Yeah, you look at it, the side that's coming up, it's going to be the 2-3-4 hitters for Durham. Jessica Green, Jocelyn Shelton, and Sydney Reddick. Three of the hitters that did some of the most damage back in the third inning. So it's huge here for Michaela Moore. Just go out and try to have a strong inning here.
First up to bat for Durham will be Jessica Green, who comes to the Lords in her first year of OCAA softball by way of Connecticut. Shout out to Connecticut. Zach, you ever watch Gilmore Girls?
I don't think I have. I've heard it. I've
great
heard
television
good,
show
heard
set
good.
In Connecticut. First pitch of the inning comes a little high from Moore, so 1-0 count is the result.
Again, we're seeing the pitch mix starting off batters with that high riser.
Strike one, good response for Moore to even things up.
And that one fooled me. At first, I thought it was going to be another rising fastball, but the dip at the end, it's just a good off-speed pitch to mix after that first pitch ball.
Moore zips that in, swing and a miss. So can the Hawks give Durham a little taste of their own medicine? We just saw the Lords give Humber nothing when the Hawks were just at bat in the bottom of the fourth.
Just got to keep momentum on your side of the field. And that's what Michaela Moore is trying to do right now for Humber.
That ball hit, takes a bit of a skip over to first, and that will be gloved down and out number one. Good play from the Hawks infield.
And partner, the best thing you can do as a pitcher is keep batters guessing of what pitch is coming next. That entire at-bat, Jessica Green, looked like she was a little step behind guessing on a fastball in the off-speeds. It's a good job mixing pitches.
How about that as Moore continues some excellent looking pitching here. That's Jocelyn Shelton up to bat now for Durham.
Durham try to set up an off-speed on the outside. No, fastball inside.
That is hit well. That will find some dirt, and a single will help get the party going here in the fifth inning for the Lords.
Shelton was sitting a fastball and looked like she got one on the inner half, and does a good job inside outing that one to right field.
Brings up Reddick at the plate for Durham. First pitch to Sydney. Reddick is swung at, popped up high, and Duano not able to come down with it. Close call right in front of us here, Zach.
Yeah, bounced up, and it was a good effort. Just pops out of the glove when she landed onto the ground.
In the NFL, they say he didn't survive contact with the ground. That's kind of what happened there.
It is the NFL season, so why not bring back some NFL terms?
Is it ever? Of course, the MLB getting into some playoff action very soon. Of course, October baseball, some wild card games right around the corner.
Big baseball down the stretch here for the Blue Jays, if you're a fan of them.
Oh, 1 count. Bunt laid down. That's handled by Ferreira over to first. And called safe. The Lords are fired up as they've got two runners on base. And, Zach, maybe a chance for Durham to pour a little more offense on here in the fifth inning.
Yeah, and really, Ferreira not at fault there. It was just playing the power of Reddick because we saw her last at bat. She pulled it right down the line. So it was sitting back, not expecting a bunt. You got to tip your cap to the batter right there.
Ball down low as Chelsea Oak up to bat.
She also pulled one down the left field line. You can see Ferreira playing a little bit tighter to the line here. If she gets that ball, expect her to step on third base and try to just throw across for the double play.
Up high for a 2-0 count. That is cracked into the Humber outfield. Glove down. Excellent work there. How about that catch from the vet, Hannah Koziolek?
Good job to track it. And I mentioned, Koziolek moves from center field to right field, so a little bit of a different play for her there, but just does a really good job tracking that softball.
Let's run that back one more time. A Hawks Sports Network replay. The sun setting here at Conroeville. Koziolek. Steps
into action. A little bit, caught it right in the palm. Those ones can be a little bit uncomfortable. You're shaking your hand out afterwards. Luckily, it's not too cold outside, so it's not a stinger.
Now it's Hannah Oak. Oak sisters hit one after the other here in this Durham batting order. And Oak hits that right over towards her coach on the third baseline.
Seems like Durham has a chant for everything. I just heard them
possibility.
Yeah, I just heard them singing the Hannah Montana theme song, obviously for Hannah Oak at the plate. They even have one for the coach.
Channeling an old Ludacris song.
Yeah, I mean, you know,
get
you got
out the way.
Like
get
I said,
out
you
got
to tip your cap to some of these chants.
Oh, 1 count for Hannah Oak, who hits it up to Ferreira, zips it over to first, and there is the out. Ending the inning thanks to a heads-up play from Humber's veteran, number 2, Alexis Ferreira.
That's why it's called the hot corner for a reason. Ferreira does such a good job at just utilizing the lateral movement there. You got to maybe be able to go side to side and have a quick first step, and that's exactly what Ferreira does. Big inning for the Hawks as they don't allow any across.
the Lords certainly looked like they were threatening there in the top of the fifth, but great defensive play for Humber to shut things down. Now, that brings us to a replay of what we saw. Keep in mind, this was final play of the inning. Ferreira on the ground, over to first. No splits needed that time.
Good lateral movement. And you see it, how she sets up at third base, she gets low to the ground, because when you do that, you allow yourself just to go either way. We saw a couple of them get by her on her right-hand side. That time on the left, has a good first step and gets that ball.
Top of the batting order for Humber is where we'll start this inning. Shay Hilpert. And once Hilpert has gotten on base, true to form, she's been doing some great work, stealing some extra bases.
Two out of the three runs scored by the Hawks, they've been Hilpert, and she has two hits on the day.
You know, Zach, it's kind of like the game within the game is the dueling dugout songs coming from both Humber and Durham.
Seems like Durham has more of like those song types, and Humber has a lot of those chants. If you know
more
what I mean. If you're catching my drift there, partner.
Gotcha.
They implement the drum. They implement
song parody.
Songs, yes. One has a drum. The other one just makes remixes of songs. Is what we're finding out here.
Shay Hilpert, the 1-2 count, looking to give Humber a leg up here in the bottom of the fifth. And Hilpert will get a little scoop shot on that. That will drop, and Hilpert, a dangerous runner, has found her way on base. That's good news for Humber. That will now bring up the fifth-year player, the outstanding old Dust Devil sweeping across the field here, Zach, but it's Alexis Ferreira up to bat.
And really, we haven't seen her power pop off yet. You know, she has the two home runs she hit earlier on in the season. A little bit lately now, it's just been getting on base. Oh, ripped by the knee there. Looked like when she dove.
Ferreira hits that up, finds some field. That will drop. So the Hawks, no outs, two on.
You've heard the old expression, a bloop and a blast. Well, we've seen two bloops. And Reese Veloci, who has the two RBIs today, step back up to the dish.
So we'll have a meeting here on the mound. Looks like Durham will be switching up the pitching here. And into the game, looks like it'll be Sydney Reddick. So pitching change here after a nice start for the Hawks offensively in the bottom of the fifth.
So looking at it here, 11 innings pitch on the year for Sydney Reddick, a 3.27 ERA. Only allowed four runs, and you know the start of the season, that's when she allowed those runs, and really ever since she hasn't allowed one. Oh, we got some good music going on here at the venue. Got some Timmy trumpets. Okay. Edwin Diaz, where are you when we need you?
So pitching change for the Lords. The Subway has arrived, Zach, for our in-between game snack. Of course, we'll have a bit of a break here before the second game of this doubleheader. These teams will run it right back right here on the Hawk Sports Network. The scheduled game time for that is 8:30, although could be also just 30 minutes after the conclusion of this game.
Mentioned it best, and you know the Subway arrived, and I saw your eyes light up a little bit there, partner. Getting a little excited to have one of those cold cuts. Dangerous hitter coming up, Reese Veloci.
popped up high. So the first batter of the game was going to land fair. We got a couple of Hawks scrambling right now, and gonna be finishing off that play with loaded bases.
Unfortunate break for Durham, but a great break for Humber. No outs, the base is loaded, and you have a big power threat in Riley DeVries stepping up to the plate. We'll take another look of what happened down that right field line right here. Looks like, oh, just was in fair territory and tips off the glove.
So excellent work there from Reese Veloci. The first year player gives her team a huge hit here. As the Hawks now have no outs, bases loaded, they have turned the tables in a big way in this ball game.
So it was her third hit of the day, and she'll be pinch run for here. Going on to run for Veloci is Angelina Bomberry, number 18. Getting a little bit more speed, you know. Bomberry, the go-ahead run right now. So trying to get everything you can is Coach Dwayne Bowles, but nonetheless, I mentioned it, Riley DeVries stepping up and having a career year, to say the least, is number 15.
DeVries takes a swing at the first pitch she sees for strike one.
Trying to jump out ahead on a fastball right there. And DeVries, like Russo does, her bat stays through the plane of the zone for so long, allowing for more contact.
Reddick's pitch is hit up high. That's between a couple of Lords. Glove down. The Hawks will bring a couple of runners through. So we'll have some runners advancing. The Hawks bring one run home to make this a single run game.
And the big thing about that hit right there, not only do you get an RBI, but both runners tag in advance up. So the tying run on third, the go-ahead at second, and Amelia Russo stepping up. That's a good job done right there by DeVries to get it deep enough for a run to score.
And that's popped up quickly. That will land. There's the game-tying run for the Hawks. The loose ball will have potentially the go-ahead run on the way home. Ill-advised as it's out. So Bomberry called out at home plate. Zach, we're all tied up at five. The Hawks with a runner on second and two outs. A lot happening there in that last play.
Yeah, a lot to unpack, you know. First off, what a job done by Amelia Russo to stay back on a fastball and drive it. It was something similar we saw earlier in the game that she did. Does it again right there.
Hannah Koziolek up to bat now for Humber. That one is hit into foul territory.
Russo representing the go-ahead run. Humber, they've exploded for some deep offense of their own.
Up high for ball one. So one count for Koziolek. Hits that hard up towards third base, and Koziolek will make it over to first. The offense continues to hum here in the bottom of the fifth for Humber. 5-5 game and two runners on.
Yeah, and I think I would give that to that hit right there to Koziolek. It was a hard hit to the left side of the third baseman. Couldn't glove it with a hot hand. So runners on the corner. We'll have a re-entry here. Megan Muir will be coming up to hit.
Megan Muir up to bat here for the Hawks. We saw her pitching earlier in the game for Humber.
So I believe this will for sure mean we'll get a new pitcher coming in next half inning.
Swing and a miss on the first ball of the at-bat.
One thing as a hitter you want to have is just stay on your back leg as long as you can. Get as much power into your swing.
Sydney Reddick throws a ball to even the count up. Reddick just looking for one more out here to try to get her team out of this jam. Best case scenario for Durham right now would be to leave this inning as a tied ball game right where we started. Big swing there, and Reddick getting ever so closer to securing that third out.
So I was wondering if there was going to be a little bit of trickery going on where Koziolek takes off for second to steal and Russo comes home, but no play put on.
That's hit up high. This is into foul territory. The Lord's not able to get under it.
Looked like Koziolek was going on that pitch right there.
So look out, the Humber Hawks getting close to a go-ahead run here in a very productive fifth inning for Humber. Great ball game so far. That pitch is low. That will allow Koziolek to scamper over to second. Hawks now with runners on second and third.
Good job by Koziolek to read that one in the dirt and take off. Smart play.
And there's strike three to end the inning, and the Humber Hawks will leave two on, and we'll leave the fifth inning with a 5-5 score. Wow, Zach, this is certainly shaping up for a dramatic finish, and what we know is always close matchups between these two top teams in the province.
It's only a regular season game, and it's this intense already. Wow. You know.
Well, Zach, you highlighted some of the playoff implications of a game like this. Here's one of those hits from Humber earlier in the inning. That dropped. That allowed a run to score for Humber. Brought them within one. Here's another look here at that great pop off the bat from Riley DeVries.
Almost a collision in the outfield there, too.
But glove down, but ultimately Humber able to advance the play and advance the agenda.
And one thing I'm just really liking that I'm seeing out of these Humber at-bats is everybody is just staying back on the ball and they're using as much power as they can. They're kind of forgetting about that big launch angle and just kind of hitting everything on a line. And that's what you want to see out of the batters. And I believe we do have a new pitcher, Zoe Skogal, to be coming in to do the pitching duties.
So the first-year pitcher coming in for Humber in a big spot here. Again, just to reiterate, in case you weren't with us for the beginning of the broadcast, we have the Humber Hawks sitting in third in the province right now. The Hawks' record this year is 12-2. Durham is 13-1. They sit just above Humber. So with a win here, the Hawks could tie for second in the province. And, of course, the second game this evening of our doubleheader will be hugely important. At any rate, no matter how this game finishes, these are massive games that we're seeing here tonight at Carnarvale.
Yeah, and you mentioned the first-year player, Zoe Skogal, coming on to pitch. She's had a very good first year. There was really one blip against the St. Clair Saints, but let's be honest here, that team over there in Windsor, they've been pretty dominant the last couple of years. Every other outing she has had, no runs allowed. She's been dominant, to say the least. She has one save on the year, which is tied for first in the OCAA. But she'll look to come in a big moment here, try to shut down the Durham Lords. If you're Humber, you just tied the game up. Now, try to shut down on the other side. This half inning could be huge for momentum going forward.
Opening up the batting in this inning for the Lords, number two, Chloe Showers. So let's see if Skogal can get another look here. Into the game for Humber. Ball one.
It's a good first pitch right there by Skogal to get things rocking and rolling here in the top half of the sixth.
There's a nice pitch thrown there to even up the count.
Have deception. I think that's the key thing for all the pitchers so far tonight. They've all had good deception from their fastball and their breaking ball. Can Skogal continue that trend here?
Hit up towards third base. Ferreira zips it over for out number one. Good start for the home field Hawks.
Like a vacuum over there at third base is number two. She does such a good job just fielding the ball and making sure she has enough time to make a strong, accurate throw over to first.
Yeah, Ferreira, such a weapon. for the Hawks. Up to bat now. We've got for the Lords, 22, Abby Suffel.
So it looks like there was a substitution made for the catcher.
Suffel takes a swing. That's over to Ferreira and calmly over to first for out number two. Looking good for the Hawks here in the sixth inning. Thus far, now bringing up to bat Natalie Clemens.
And, you know, sometimes you think it'd be a little bit intimidating for a first-year player to come into a game with this magnitude and this, you know, intensity. But Skogal has just done such a good job, you know, missing barrels, and that's the key thing right now.
One oh count here. Skogal sends that one in. That's hit off the bat. Over to first. Not going to be in time.
Tip your cap once again. Reese Veloci. My oh my. The shortstop making some incredible plays and throws. And that one as bang bang as you can get. Just unfortunate break for Humber.
Grace Hearns. Well, watch that go by. Over to second for the steal. That ball hits the dirt. So safely stealing second.
And that's the right side you want to throw it at if you're the catcher. You can see there, it was placed perfectly. It was just a hair out of the reach of Veloci.
So Napanese Grace Hearns up to bat. The top of the batting order here for the Lords.
Probably the most dangerous hitter for the Durham Lords.
And stealing over to third now. That's not going to be in time. So some heads up stealing going on here.
That's, again, just a really good play by Hearns to one, fake the bunt and draw in Ferreira. Because, you know, you saw Humbert, nobody had the wheel play on. So the shortstop was not already coming over when Ferreira was coming in.
So Natalie Clemens on third base now. That would be the go-ahead run for Durham. Two outs. Humber just needs one more to seal the deal here. Humber looking to get out of this half inning. As we entered, all tied up. Durham inching closer to that go-ahead run here. Zoe's pitch swung at. Over to Zoe, takes a weird bounce, Zach, and that will allow the first run of the inning to home plate. The Lords take the lead here, 6-5 off of just a softball gods putting a weird spin on that ball.
Yeah, you can see Skogal tried to take that one. And this was the play by Veloci across the diamond where just beat it down the line with Clemens. But, yeah, that one right there, you know, it's a really 50-50 chance. You can either wait for that hop or try to take it before. You know, Skogal elected to take it after the hop, and it was just unfortunate break for the side of the Hawks. Durham, they strike back.
Zoe's pitch, opportunity. There it is for out number three, but Durham able to squeak out the go-ahead run. Humber Hawks are going to have to dial up some offense here. Try to put a little pressure on Durham, but as it stands right now, the team just above Humber in the provincial standings gets out of that inning with a 6-5 lead.
So this was the run that scored. You see, Skogal elected to take it on that second hop. So again, it was a very 50-50 play. You could have taken it on the hop, on that big one, but she tried to do it on the second one. Unfortunately, couldn't. And That's how it happens right there. You just try to take on that second hop, and it bounces away from you. Nonetheless, Humber does have a good chance to try to get some offense back. As we're getting ready to get things going, it'll be Melissa Hanfeld, Allison McLaughlin, and then back to the top of the order in Shea Hilpert. This is the part of the Humber Hawks order that's struggled just a little bit offensively so far today. 0 for 4 is the bottom two batters for the Hawks. Well, they'll be trying to come back. And wow, look at that.
How about
the moon?
The moon. Not quite full, Zach, but a little exclamation mark on
it's good enough.
Gorgeous night for softball here at Connerville Park. Up to bat first for the Humber Hawks, number 14, Melissa Hanfeld. And she'll hit that up high, and that will go foul. So Hanfeld will.
And I think the real question here was, did the catcher make contact with the ball? Because if she did, that would have been fair. Umpire elected that she didn't. We'll double check it here, and it's tough to say if her glove or even her knee hit it, but nonetheless, we'll continue on.
Hanfeld will watch that go low, bringing us to a 1-1 count.
A leadoff base runner would be huge here for the Hawks.
Got a piece of it that time. That's good for strike two.
Hanfeld, I've been talking about it all night. Humber, their at-bats have been really good because they're staying on their back leg. Hanfeld, a couple times here, she's lunged out forward.
As a strong breeze overtakes Connerville Park.
Got some windstorms and sandstorms hitting off.
Well, Zach, it has not rained in the city of Toronto for 13 days. That's approaching an all-time record for Toronto of dry days.
Really?
So the dirt is ready to get whipped up, I'll tell you that. Zach, the record for number of days without measurable rainfall in the city of Toronto, 26. We're halfway there with this current dry stretch.
I won't lie, it's been a nice dry stretch, been able to slip in my window open every night.
Popped up by Hanfeld. A nice drawn out at bat here. Hanfeld not going down easy. 2-2 count. And Zach, it's good news for OCAA baseball. Doesn't look like we're getting much rain at all in the next few days, so great baseball and softball weather for the OCAA.
And soccer. We have, I believe, the next baseball, men's baseball game for the Humber Hawks will be played on Sunday.
And there's the strikeout as Hanfeld goes down and the first out of the inning secured. Good effort there by Sydney Reddick pitching for the Lords.
Another look here at the high fastball by Reddick, and it gets Hanfeld to just chase. See here, a good fastball. We'll take behind it. And pinch hitting here for Allison McLaughlin will be Maddie Bolson.
Bolson swings big on the first pitch she sees. Zach, this is the only two softball games in the province tonight. And popped up high as Bolson sends that into foul territory, and it's gloved down for out number two. Tomorrow we have some more OCAA action. Only two games on the schedule. The Fanshawe Falcons will be traveling to St. Clair to take on the Saints. Up to bat now, we are back to the top of the order for Humber. Shea Hilpert, base stealer extraordinaire, zips that dangerously over towards her own dugout. Photographer Diego had to make a heads-up move. And look, he put his body on the line. He protects the camera, not himself.
Yeah,
that's the real professional.
That's the key right there. Got to protect the camera. Those cost a lot more.
Hilpert runs up at that one. Ball one.
Yeah, one thing to note. You said run up there. And what you mean, if you don't understand at home, is she does that slap hit where it gets the running start.
Another Humber Hawk great who used to do that run-up move was the one and only Megan Murphy, who is now an assistant coach with this Humber Hawks team. A lot of Dwayne Bowles' former players stay on the roster as assistants.
This is just a really good at-bat from Hilpert. You kind of keep seeing it, that slap hit maneuver. She does a good job of just keeping the bat throughout the zone, even when she's moving in the box. You know, staying stationary and keeping the bat level is hard enough. Keeping it.
How about that? Hilpert slaps it up, and she makes it over to first and slides in there. Hilpert all heart. And once Hilpert is on base, she is a dangerous lady. So good look for the Hawks. They have two outs, but Hilpert able to get on base.
Good speed. Again, I mean, out of the leadoff spot, that is so clutch to have. And that'll be her fourth hit of the day, so that ties her career high in a game that she set back on September 21st against the Sheridan Bruins.
Alexis Ferreira up to bat now for Humber.
Right hitter, right time.
Up high, Hilpert over to first. She's safe. Stretched out there.
We know Hilpert has the speed, and drawing the throw like that is pretty big because you have the catcher on your mind.
Goes in low. Hilpert stays on first. 2-1 count. Can Ferreira, the leader for Humber, give the team some juice right now? Hits that up way high and out of play for the foul.
And the thing that's impressed me most this season so far from Alexis Ferreira, you know, the average being at 500, that's pretty big. But another big stat, her on-base percentage being over 600, sitting at 604 coming into today. That's massive to have, especially in the number two spot.
Ferreira almost hit by that one. She is going to catch a piece of that. So she makes her way, and that ball even ultimately hit the umpire as well. So a couple of human beings nailed by that pitch.
And another good hitter. We'll make sure the umpire is okay. Looked like he caught that one on the stomach. Another clutch hitter so far today, Reese Veloci. 3-for-3 with 2 RBIs. The first year player having herself an incredible rookie campaign.
Veloci swings at the first pitch. She sees, goes foul. Humber down by one here after surrendering a single run in the top of the sixth. That broke the tie. Hawks with two on. Already suffered two outs. First year, Veloci makes something happen. She hits that up towards the second baseline, and there is the final out of the inning. So after 6 innings of play, it's the Durham Lords who are ahead by a hair, 6-5.
And Humber, you know, tried to have the two-out rally, but that one, you know, ultimately just doesn't go their way. Now the Hawks will try to shut it down for one more half and then get things rolling on offense. As we mentioned, this game looked pretty big for the standing-wise. You look at it, Humber sitting at 12-2. While the Durham Lords sit at 13-1. This matchup, could kind of really determine whether or not, you know, Humber or Durham finishes second, possibly first in the OCAA.
Yeah, you look at the OCAA standings, and it's really just three teams who are gobbling up all the wins. You have the St. Clair Saints 14-0, Durham 13-1, Humber 12-2. And like you mentioned earlier, Zach, the next best team in the league is 5-7 with Seneca. We have Mohawk at 4-10. We just rattle off the whole league. 3-10 are the Conestoga Condors. Lambton Lions are 3-9. Sheridan Bruins 3-11. And the Fanshawe Falcons, the Birds, are at 3-9. But just to illustrate, it's really such a separation between 1-2-3 and the rest of the OCAA.
Yeah, and these three, really the three softball programs that we have seen so far over the last couple years, Durham has been dominant. They had that stretch from 2015 to 2018 where they were just the provincial champions, and then St. Clair has come out of nowhere as well. And Humber, they've always been a good softball program. It's just been, you know, all the pieces finally clicking together. This team this year, you know, the rookies especially have impressed me a lot. You see on the mound Zoe Skogal, first-year player. She's really stepped into a good role in the back end of this bullpen, coming in whenever she's needed and just shutting the door. You look at Reese Veloci at shortstop. Coming in and becoming the starting shortstop for any team in your first year is hard to do, but also batting near 500 on the year in your rookie campaign, that's pretty good.
You said it, partner. Here's Jocelyn Shelton at bat to begin the final inning of regulation. Ball one. Both Humber and Durham in their last 10 games are 9-1. That slap, that'll find a bit of open space, and that's good for a single to open up the seventh inning.
Shelton so far on the day, 3-for-4. She lined down her first at-bat and then three straight singles. And then another dangerous hitter here in Sydney Reddick.
The young lady we're currently seeing pitching on the other side for the Lords. Here she is at bat. Opening up this at bat with a ball. Once again, it's Skugal. Zoe sends in a great strike there. Hawks are already trailing, can ill afford to allow any offense from Durham here in the top of the seventh. Hit up high, that is deep into Humber territory, and gloved down by Cozy Olek. That's who you want under a ball, and a big play like that is the fifth year player, number 12.
Yeah, and a good job right there to track it. You know, we had a little bit of twilight about, I want to say, 20-ish minutes ago, but now getting a little bit easier to read that ball with the sky getting darker and the lights here at Connervale.
Still, I mean, we've seen the dirt kind of get kicked up around here, a bit breezy, and with all this dry weather, we do have some breezy conditions. Again, Zach, it's that east wind coming off the lake. Here we go with an 0-1 count,
and it's Chelsea Oak at the plate. She had an RBI double back in that big third inning for Durham. And she started this game for the Lords, had a pretty dominant pitching performance as well.
And taken off to second here, and the Hawks not able to get the throw in time.
Nice pick and grab there by Veloci. Again, just tough there. Got to try to get that ball on the first base side. Makes the tag very much easier for the shortstop or second baseman that's covering.
So Jocelyn successfully makes her way to second. Zoe's pitch called a ball.
Dropping just under the knees there. It's a tough break, but a smart pitch location if you're number 8.
A 1-1 count with one out and a runner on second. Taking off here, Ferreira looks at the runner and able to make the throw over to first. So there's out number 2, but the Lords once again have that runner in threatening position as Jocelyn's on third now.
Shelton heads up base running right there. She kind of kept creeping towards third base, and then once Ferreira lets it go, she's already about halfway down that line, so she's going to take third quite easily. Hannah Oak 0-for-3 so far today.
Oak will hit that, and it's gloved down. Excellent work there, and that's the center fielder taking care of business for Humber.
Tip your cap to number 3 in white. Have yourself a game, Shea Hilpert, laying it out all on the line. Wow, what a grab.
So the Humber Hawks will enter the seventh inning, the bottom of the seventh, down a run, and look at that grab.
That's a web gem right there, if I've ever seen one, partner. Wow.
And Hilpert has just been all over the diamond. I mean, she's done such good work getting on base, and then, of course, the base stealing is just her bread and butter.
Key thing about that play right there, a great first step. Off the bat, she read the ball so well and was able to get to that one. And, you know, the biggest part about that is the ball doesn't get down, the run doesn't score, so Hummer still only trails by one. You got some good hitters coming up too. Riley DeVries, Amelia Russo, and Hannah Cozy Olek. Those are the three that have had some good days at the plate.
Starting off this bottom of the seventh for Humber, Riley DeVries, and still on the mound, as you see there, is number 29, Sydney Reddick. Hawks looking for the walk-off dub, or at least just a single run to force this to extra innings. Swinging at that first pitch, strike one.
Looked like Reddick started things off with an off-speed pitch. Had DeVries leaning on that front foot a little bit. The key thing I've been mentioning all night long, stay on that back leg if you're the Hawks. Drive that ball.
Up high for ball one.
DeVries had a sack fly her last time up. That brought him the fourth run.
Slapped, finding a bit of space there. That ball makes its way into the Lords outfield, and on first base is Riley DeVries. Great start for Humber.
All year long, DeVries has been having good at-bats and continues it right there. Staying on the back leg and powers a ground ball through the hole on the left. And someone who's had good at-bats all day long, Amelia Russo.
Russo will hit that one up high. That was the broadcaster kibosh right
there. It really
there.
Was. My bad, Millie. My bad.
Big at bat for Hannah Cozy Olek. She had big grab defensively just a few plays ago, and the fifth year player with a chance to make something happen offensively. Ball one.
Look over at first to DeVries when she's getting her lead. Has a little bit of happy feet over there. She's trying to draw a throw or make the catcher think that she's going to take off her second.
Seen some good pitching from Sydney Reddick. Trying to close out this game. Her team is up one. The Lords looking to steal game one of this doubleheader. Again, here on the Hawks Sports Network, we'll have game two 30 minutes after the completion of this game, just enough time for me and Zach to crush as many 6-inch Subway sandwiches as we can.
Cold cuts on the way.
Up high. That's out of play.
Head coach Dwayne Bowles is going to have a conversation here with the home plate umpire. He saw something. And he's going to let the ump know, just, hey, just, you know, keep an eye out for any illegal motions happening on the mound.
One 2 count for Cozy Olek. Make that a 2-2 count. DeVries makes it safely back to first. Giddy up, partner. This is just what you want when you see a game like this on the schedule. A dramatic finish is what we most certainly have.
That intensity, I'll crank it up from 10 to 100.
Cozy Olek blasts it real high. That is deep into the Lords outfield and glove down, and even a little stumble in the defense there. But two outs now with DeVries on first. That brings up for the Humber Hawks number 8, Zoe Skugel. Huge at bat for Zoe.
Came in late to pitch in this one, and she'll get her first at bat here in the seventh.
tremendous amount of pressure on the first year player. And the pitcher for the Lords, Reddick, trying to seal the deal, the fourth year vet. How about that blast? Finding a bit of space. That's into left field. Humber will advance the runners. So now on first and second, Zoe Skuga. How about that? Fantastic work. Huge moment of the game, Zach, and seemingly unfazed by the pressure, keeping her team in this game.
That's what you like to see. I mean, your first plate appearance and you have a great cut like that. She stayed fully on the backside and just powers one.
Up now for Humber. Melissa Hanfeld. And that pitch in low. Good job to keep that one from getting away as the catcher keeps that ball in front of her.
This is what you're hoping to see out of Hanfeld this at bat, is just try to stay back on something. You don't need to have a crazy big fly, just something that you can advance runners.
Popped up high. McIntyre tries to get under it.
Just stay on a ball and just kind of drive it through the infield. You don't need any big heroics right now. You just got to keep, you know, passing on the torch. You have a lot of good hitters in this Humber Hawks lineup. Just keep passing that torch down.
Swing and a miss, and that puts the Lords one strike away from closing out this game. Huge play coming up. Hanfeld at bat, gets a piece of it to stay alive.
Now you're just in fight mode if you're Hanfeld. Whatever you can, if you're gonna swing, you gotta at least get a piece of it. Stay alive and keep prolonging this at bat.
That one's low and K-Mac does just enough to keep it in front of her.
Yeah, tip your cap to the catcher right there, McIntyre. She's doing everything she can to keep it in front.
This is too much pressure for me to handle on an empty stomach, Zach. 2-2 count, two outs, two on. Popped up high, trying to get under it. There it is, the final out of the ball game. The Durham Lords win back-to-back games against the Humber Hawks. One on Sunday, and the first game of the doubleheader goes in favor of the visiting team.
Yeah, and both games between these two squads, one run affairs. And I mean, you've got to tip your cap to both teams. Humber played a tough 1-7, just fell a little bit short. Partner, we're not going away though. We still got one more, and it's going to be a great pitching matchup.
Boy, the intensity dialed all the way up there to an 11. Final Tap reference. Now let's see if the Hawks can get their revenge. They know that they've already lost the season series. Of course, you play three times against each other. Two games have gone to the Durham Lords, one here this evening. But again, these are huge games. There's a lot of softball left here, and we'll see how the Hawks respond here in game two of our doubleheader, scheduled for 8:30 right here on the Hawks Sports Network. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.